When we hear the name Las Vegas, we think about a world where the wealthy and powerful hit the strip at night to try their luck at the casinos and dance until the break of dawn at the most sizzling nightclubs. It's a city full of wealth, opulence, and glamour, but that's not all. There is another world far below the city streets, and in this secret place lurks something most people dismiss as an urban legend. It's something that people might not want to encounter when they visit the city, even though it's as real as the casinos and theaters above it. There's a secret under the Las Vegas skyline. Every year, thousands of people head to the Las Vegas Strip to gamble, drink, and have fun. But underneath this glittering world full of lights and attractions, like the Grand Canals at the Venetian Las Vegas or the Las Vegas High Roller, is a secret city. The flood tunnels that became homes. In 1990, the city of Las Vegas built a network of flood tunnels beneath the streets, much like the subway tunnels underneath New York City. But somewhere along the way, people started making their way into these tunnels. But how did they get in? Tunnel entrances are in plain sight. To most people, the tunnel entrances appear to be nothing more than an overpass. But a couple of meters in is a network of flood tunnels that extends 300 miles underneath the city. And something about these tunnels has lured people in, and there's a reason for this. The tunnels are home to a certain class. While most people balk at the thought of living in a tunnel network, for some, it's a saving grace. This is particularly true for people who suffer from mental issues, addiction, and poverty. Sadly, the world above can't accommodate their needs, but these tunnels can at least offer some shelter. Some folks actually choose this life. The network of tunnels provides shelter to many people, but some folks actually choose to live here for reasons other than necessity, such as nomadic travelers who find it cheaper to stay here than in a hotel in the Las Vegas Strip. But things down here don't work the way they do up there. It's impossible to tell whether it's night or day. Most residents lose track of time here and find it difficult to tell whether it's nighttime or daytime. Sometimes, when our clock says 6 o'clock, you don't know whether it's morning or in the evening, explained Shay, a 53-year-old woman who lives in these tunnels. She added, "If some light comes in at the end of the tunnel, we know it's daytime. But for some, this existence isn't exactly a paradise. Some consider these tunnels exile." A tunnel dweller named Anthony moved down here after serving some time in prison, and Business Insider quoted him saying, "This is how society treats us. They want us to be invisible. But we are here, we want to be seen, our story must be heard." But what do these tunnel networks look like? Some areas are actually comfortable. Some folks have been able to fully furnish the interior of their tunnel space. In fact, this is often an indication that the person has been living here for a long time and has no plans of moving out. They could move if they wanted to. Items like tables, mattresses, and other furniture were not easy to bring down into the tunnels, and it would cost way too much money to remove them. Hence why dwellers would rather stay put. But this can pose a problem if Mother Nature were to strike. Flooding could be a major problem. In 1975, a massive flood left Las Vegas in a state of disarray. This ultimately led to the construction of the flood tunnels. So obviously, the folks living down here know they're sitting on a time bomb, as a severe rainstorm could force them out without any warning. Flood tunnel-related deaths have occurred. Fear of floods isn't just paranoid delusion. In 2017, a lot of people drowned to death in these tunnels after water flooded through the network and dragged them to their untimely demise. But flooding isn't the only threat these tunnel dwellers face. Overdoses are a common issue. Some tunnel dwellers suffer from controlled substance issues, which leads to overdoses. Unfortunately, it takes time for emergency responders to search for a patient who has OD'd within the tunnel network. And in some cases, dwellers will hesitate calling authorities right away because they're afraid of legal repercussions. Illegal activity is common here. It's not uncommon for people to perform all kinds of illegal activities down here, including the ultimate crime. There is no cameras here, and I've even heard of murders. Angel, a resident who calls these tunnels home, told Business Insider, "These shady activities have ultimately caught unwanted attention from authorities. Cops are on high alert." The increase in criminal activities have led the police to monitoring the tunnel entrances more frequently, which has forced many of the dwellers to leave the tunnels and their belongings to avoid being captured by police. But that's not the only issue these people face. They lack the basics. When Angel was asked what she missed most about living in a regular home in the world above, she laughed and explained, "A toilet and a shower. The last time I took a shower, I cried." And others can sympathize with her plight. There's no plumbing. Living in the tunnels isn't easy by any means, especially since a lot of the luxuries we take for granted aren't available, such as plumbing. But some residents have found a way around this by using a whirlpool as a makeshift bath. But plumbing isn't the only thing these people lack. Lighting is pretty scarce. The network of tunnels is virtually dark, and the only light source around here comes from the grating that was designed to let the water in during a rainstorm. So at night, it's all pitch black down here. But despite this inconvenience, some folks have chosen to live here out of necessity. One dweller moved here for love. According to Business Insider, 50-year-old Rusty had no other choice but to come down here because of her husband's past. "I used to have an apartment and cats and dogs. I lived on welfare, but my husband couldn't live with me anymore because of his past. No landlord accepted him anymore. We've been married for 12 years. I wanted to be with him, so I went into the tunnels with him," she shared. But she almost lost her life. The heat is unbearable. It's important to remember that Las Vegas is in the middle of the desert, and deserts get very hot in the summer. Now, most people stand in front of a fan or look for an air-conditioned place to stay and perhaps cool off with a refreshing glass of water. But most dwellers don't have that. Neither did Rusty, and she suffered a heat stroke, which could have been fatal at her age. And yet, she stays here, like many of her fellow dwellers. Some people will never leave here. There are approximately 2,000 people living in the network of flood tunnels, and many of them have no intention of leaving. In fact, a man named Craig explained to The Sun why that is. "I wouldn't want to be homeless anywhere else. We're out of sight and out of mind here in Vegas. And yet, the tunnels have gotten lots of attention. The tunnel has attracted many. The network of tunnels has brought in news crews, television shows, and a ton of graffiti artists. But that doesn't mean that this spot should be on anyone's travel itinerary, because it is still deemed quite a dangerous place. And yet, it is so close to the casinos that dwellers have made out like bandits. Dwellers cruise the strip for cash. Many of the tunnel entrances are within range of the casinos in the Las Vegas Strip, which is great for dwellers like Steven. He and others like him walk into the casinos looking for chips that gamblers might have dropped in order to cash in. But the dwellers also get help from a kind-hearted foundation. There's a light at the end of the tunnel. Journalist Matthew O'Brien has been researching and interviewing the tunnel dwellers for several years. He even wrote a book called Beneath the Neon, Life and Death in the Tunnel of Las Vegas. He's also the founder of Shine a Light Foundation that provides the dwellers with different services. But is there a more permanent solution for these people? The tunnels will remain a shelter. Although the tunnels were never meant to be a homeless shelter, there's enough space to accommodate everyone and then some. So for the time being, the tunnels will continue to serve their unofficial purpose until the city of Las Vegas finds a more permanent housing solution for the tunnel dwellers. Meanwhile, the tunnel network continues to grow. The tunnel network is expanding. The Las Vegas Flood Control District continues its work to expand the tunnel network so that in the event of a powerful rainstorm, the conduits can direct over 1 million gallons of rainwater to Lake Mead. But the homeless will undoubtedly continue to move in deeper into these new tunnels as they become available.